Hi guys, hello guys, welcome to my channel. I still remain your girl, Ada Jesus, Ada Chichi. Yeah guys, how are you guys doing? I hope you guys are wonderful. Yeah, you guys are so amazing. Thanks for subscribing. Yeah, I just want to talk about tithe, you know. You see, don't be deceived. Don't be deceived. People keep saying, don't pay your tithe. Don't do like that. Don't do this. Don't do this. Yeah, you know, I like to read scripture. If I'm doing things, you know, I like to use scripture, you know, to do my argument so that at least... If I'm saying you yourself, you know, your own time, your own quiet time, you go and read. You see, there's this celebrity that came, you know, he was saying since he's stopping, he's tight, and things is still working well, things is moving fine, you know, that his business is booming, something like that. So I laughed. And now I was asking so many questions. I said, is it written that if you don't pay your tithe, God will not bless you? Your business will not move? Is it written that if you pay your tithe, that is only when God will bless you? You know, you see, people, the way people look at things, the way people reason things, what you don't know, try to ask, you know, that you are going to church, that does not mean that maybe you, because you go to church, you really know what church is all about, you know, or maybe you read your Bible. Bible is not a novel. You read Bible, you believe that, you are comfortable. Yeah, the way you reason Bible is different from the way others, you know, people who are really called, you know, using it. Bible is not just ordinary novel, you know. That is why God said that whatever you're doing, you should make sure that you walk by the Spirit, you know. You get connected through the Spirit of God so that if you are reading the Bible, you will have different understanding, you know, by the understanding of the Holy Spirit. You will not just understand it, understanding in the world, you know, because people in the world understand Bible in different way. You know, they don't understand it the way the Spirit of God will lead you as a Christian. You know, so you see people react on it. People were like, you know, saying, you know, saying somewhere like supporting the guy. And I said, no, you know, I cannot just keep quiet. I just have to make this video, make it clear. Pay your tithe as a Christian. Anyone that tell you don't pay tithe is deceiving you. It's deceiving you. Pay your tithe, you know. Yeah, pay your tithe, pay your offering, you know, sow a seed. Yeah, it's good. Support the work of God. Support the work of God. Don't do it like a save. You know that people who do eye service. You know that people who do eye service. You know, you are making a mistake because if you are doing something in the hands of God, you are not doing it with your heart. I mean, that blessing is just hanging. It is not, don't expect God to bless you or expect, I mean, something good to come because it's eye service, you know. You don't do it, I will read it. I will open the book of Ephesians and read it for you so that you will know what I'm talking. Let it not be like maybe I am just talking because I want to talk, you know. Yeah, that's why I like to use my scripture to back up whatever I'm doing. So if you are doing things, make sure you walk according to the Spirit. Let no one deceive you. Pay your tithe, give offering, you know, according to, I mean, give what you have. Don't do it maybe to please a sister or brother or even to please a man of God. Do it to please God. And look at yourself. When I see people struggle of paying offering in the house of God or doing things in the house of God, it's if you don't have. If you don't have, yes, it's between you and your God. Don't go and steal if you don't have. Don't go and steal. I said, okay, let me please this man of God, or let me please this woman of God, or let me please this sister. But if you are working, you are earning money, what will stop you, I mean, not to give in the hands of God, or not to, I mean, sow a seed, or not to pay your offering, or not to do your contribution? I mean, there is no amount that you spend, you know, in the hands of God that is in vain. Once I'm concerned, I know how the things of God works. I know it works, yeah. So when I see people, you know, being deceived, many stop paying tithe, many stop doing what they're supposed to do, you know, they believe that, it is written, this, that. Yeah, if you stop paying tithe, you stop giving offering, stop doing what you're supposed to do for God, know that you are just out of line. You are walking flesh now. You are not walking according to the Spirit. You are walking out of flesh. You have to rebuke that spirit and know that it's not God that is talking. Know that it's not the Holy Spirit that is leading you. You have to come back. You have to go back to Bethel. You have to go back where you belong and know that the step you are taking or the one you've already took is not, I mean, from God. So you have to ask God for mercy. Let no one deceive you. not know what to say because people, the way they reason things, in a, wrongly. They don't reason it, I mean, as a child of God. You cannot just come to social media and you say, that since you stop paying tithe, your business is moving. Your business is moving. This, I mean, no. Say no, say no. When people talk something that you know, I mean, that is not rejected, you have the power. I said, I have given you the authority. God has given you the power of life and death is in your tongue to reject any negative word that is coming to social media. People that will come to, I know some people will laugh at it. Some people, you know, enjoy it. They say this. Yeah, guys, I don't just want to take your time. I want you to see the importance of paying tithe. If you are paying tithe, make sure you don't pay it because pastor pushed you to pay. Don't pay it because a sister pushed you to pay. Pay it because you have to. You are supporting the work of God. You are doing what Bible said. He said, obey me. He said you should obey him. You obey me and my word. Whatever you ask, you know, you do what? It shall be given to you. That is the word of God. You are obeying the word of God. You are doing it because you're a child of God. You pray. You go to church, you work in a department, it's part of it. Yeah, you serve God, you contribute in your only two way. You know, the way, what you have. No one is telling you to steal. No one is telling you if you don't have, you must go and borrow or you go and steal and give. I mean, even if you steal and give, I mean, God will don't receive such thing. You are even killing yourself. So it's better you don't even steal, not to talk of steal money that you I mean, in fact, don't even steal, you don't have. So, but let no one deceive and say, don't pay tithe. You must pay your tithe and pay your offering as a child of God. Yeah, I just want to read because I like using scripture to back up whatever I'm doing. So that let it not be like maybe I am speaking flesh. Yeah, I'm reading the book of Malachi. Yeah, I'm reading the book of Malachi. Malachi chapter 3. Malachi chapter 3, verse 1. You know, yeah. But I'll be cutting it because I will not be able to read it. Just go and read the book of Malachi chapter 3 verse 1 to the end. You will know what tithe is all about and you will see the reason of why is as a Christian, as a child of God, is very important for us to pay our tithe and give an offering. Offering and paying tithe. When we say offering it has many definitions. If you buy a car, and sow a seed is an offering. You will build a church is an offering. You are building the house of God is the same offering. You sow a seed is offering. You give normal offering is the same offering. You know, you bless a sister in the church and say to you, maybe you take a sister, you are still doing what God told you to give. You are still doing what God told you to do. You know, you say you want to take care of this sister, maybe it's not working, it's not doing, or this brother, you know. Want to take care of pastors every Sunday or every day you'll be doing this, you are still supporting the things of God because he said we should help one another. It's still the things of God. So if someone is telling you don't give, I mean, don't pay your tithe, I mean, the person is deceiving you. And you, this brother that is saying that since you stop, just have it in mind that you have robbed God. God is merciful. You might see yourself that you are blessed. You don't know, let's say put it, maybe you don't know whether if maybe you did not rob God. Maybe where you are might not be where you're supposed to be. You might be seeing it like, my business is still the same. I'm still moving. But you have robbed God. You have robbed God. Yeah, guys, let it not be like maybe I'm just talking for talking. Say, look at the reason why you must give offering in the house of God and why you must pay tithe. I'm taking it from the book of Malachi chapter 3. I'm starting from verse 4. From verse 4, verse 4 said, then shall the offering of Judah and Jerusalem be pleasant unto the Lord as in the day of old and as in the former years. And I will come near to you to judgment, and I will be shift weakness against the adulterers and against false and against those that oppress the hearing in the weeks, the widows, you know, and the fatherless. And that turn aside the stranger, you know, from his right and fear not, you know, let me cut it. He now said, for I am the Lord, I change it not. I am the Lord, I change not. Therefore, ye sons of Jacob are not consumed. 7 say, even from the days of your father, ye are gone away from my ordinances and have not kept them. Return unto me, and I will return unto you, said the Lord of hosts. But he said, where shall we return? You see what God said? He said, return unto me. And in the angst, where shall we return? Believing that you can be serving God, but you are not with him. You can be serving God. You think that you are serving God. You think that you have good contact with him. But the Holy Spirit don't live in you. He said, return unto me. Return unto me, and I will return unto you, said the Lord of hosts. But he said, where shall we return? Then look what God said. He said, will a man rob God? This is what Jesus said. Will a man rob God? Yet he have robbed me. But he said, wherein have we robbed thee? In tithe and offering. You see what he said? Return unto me, and I will return unto you, said the Lord of hosts. But he said, where? He asked the answer question, where shall we return? He now asks, will a man rob God? Yet he have robbed me. But he said, wherein have we robbed thee? In tithe and offering. That is a reply. Jesus' reply. He now said, ye are cursed with a curse, for ye have robbed me, even this whole nation. So what do you want to hear again? What do you want to hear again? I'm reading here. Malachi chapter 3. Go and read it. From verse 1 to the end. So if you are not paying your tithe, you rob God. You are not giving offering, you rob God. So if someone, start telling you don't pay offering, don't pay your tithe. If you pay or you don't pay, God will bless you. It is not written here that he said he will bless you. But he said, ye are cursed with a curse, for ye have robbed me. So that is to say, if you are not paying your tithe, you see, you still have your own reward. Ye are cursed with a curse, for he have robbed me, even this world, even this whole nation. So that is it. So if you are doing something, you have to really know what the word of God is all about. You don't just, do things that you want to do. You don't just follow crowds. You don't just hear what people are saying. You just capitalize on it. Follow the word of God. Read your word of God. Read the word of God. Read your Bible. Follow the word of God. Follow his word. So you hear people saying, if this celebrity, this guy came and said, since he stopped, he has robbed God. So don't be among those who are robbing God. And that will not be your portion. So pay your tithe, pay your offering, support the work of God as a child of God. Do it with all your heart. Don't do it, what is making people, some of them, they do things wrongly. Don't do something eye service. So that they will know that, yes, you are doing things. Don't do something eye service. If you want to do something with all your heart. Do it. Don't do it because this person is doing it. You want to know competition. So you are giving because, yes, Bible said give. So as you do so, you'll be blessed. Yeah, guys, just tell me what you think. I have to do this video so that you will not be deceived. Paying your tithe, pay your offering, supporting the work of God is very good. Do it that you are doing it. You are doing it because you are a Christian, because you are a child of God. You are obeying the word of God because you believe in God. Don't do it because you want to receive from God. Do it because you are doing it because it is written that we should pay our offering and pay our tithe. And forget the blessing that follow it. God knows. Let God do his part. Don't help God. Allow him to do his part. But just obey him because he said we should obey his word. So, guys, just tell me what you think about this message. Drop your comments and don't forget to press the bell so that you'll be up. Anytime I upload video, you will receive it. So, drop your comment. Drop your comment and tell me what you think about this video. I love you guys, but remember that Jesus loves you so much. You guys are so powerful. You guys are so amazing. Thanks for watching. Subscribe. Bye, guys, and stay cool. Remember that Jesus loves you and never you give up. Bye-bye, guys.